Hey folks, and welcome back to the channel. Now I'm super excited for this video today because I've wanted one of these for such a long time. And to be clear, I still don't have one, but I have loaned one. Actually, I would need two. Two were not available, so I've got one. But still doesn't mean we can't test it. Now, some of you may be familiar with the classic Pultec program equalizer. Well, today I have, Jesus, this is heavy, so heavy. Oh. I've got the AudioScape EQP-A. Yes, I have. Look at this thing. I mean, the build quality right off the bat is just unbelievable. It just feels glorious. But my God, this thing weighs an absolute ton. So there we go. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to shoot this out against the A-Design's Hammer, which I do happen to own. Now, the A-Design's Hammer is supposed to be a Pultec, or it's in that kind of realm, shall we say. So we can kind of compare apples to apples. But I just want to see what difference the real thing makes. Because so I'm told, and so I've led been led to believe, as I've done a little bit of research, this is about the closest you're going to get to the real thing, without remortgaging your house to buy the real thing. So, you know, according to AudioScape's website, it's pretty much a component-for-component remake of the original. Or as damn close as they could get. Let's go and have a look. Alright then. So we're in Pro Tools, and I'm using the track Is It Any Wonder by Rosellas today. So to give you an idea of what the track sounds like, if you've not yet heard it, it's a little bit like this. Right, cool. So, seeing as though I only have, what I would usually do is have the hammer on the mix bus to give that kind of Pultec-y lift. However, given I've only got one AudioScape, we're going to have a look at it on an individual channel. So if I turn off this micro shift, let's have a look at these acoustics. Alright, let's take this section. Alright, so with the hammer in, so as you can hear, it's doing a little boost on the top end. In fact, I'll tell you what settings I've got. So I'm boosting 3 dB at 100 and 4 dB at about 10k. Let's have a listen to what the Pultec can do. Okay, so my initial thoughts are the Pultec sounds a hell of a lot more airy. It's got this kind of sparkliness on the it's just absolutely gorgeous. That is just gorgeous. It sounds incredible. And as you can see, I'm pushing the Pultec up to like 7. And it doesn't sound harsh, like, ever. I can just keep pushing it. Whereas the hammer, I know from experience using the hammer that if you push that too far, it sounds like shit. So you've just got to tickle it. Wow, that is incredible. All right. Out of interest, let's get ourselves the old UAD Pultec. Where are we? And let me just quickly match my settings. So I'm going 2 on the lows. And the lows are at 100. Attenuating 3 on the lows. And then I'm boosting 7 at 10k. And I'm attenuating 3 at 20k. Let's see how they sound versus each other. Well, to me, the UAD plugin sounds more like the hammer than it does the Pultec. Although, maybe that's unfair. It is in the ballpark, but the UAD plugin definitely sounds thinner to my ears. The actual Pultec has got way more sort of body to it. And you noticed I had to dial the highs down on the UAD plugin because it's way harsher than the real one is. Wow, I mean, the one thing this says to me is that I'm going to end up spending a lot of money on Pultec. Hey, get in touch on the website and book in now. Oh, I just... Wow. What else can we try this on? I'll tell you what we can do. Let's try it on good old kick drum. Let's knock that sucker off there. Pull that back to how it was. Let's have a listen to kick. What we got here? Thank you. That that's one of the only pieces of gear in a very long time, other than the Smart C2, that's brought a genuine smile to my face. That is outrageous. Let's try it on snare as well. Why not? When in Rome, right? You know, the way things are going, I'm gonna have to buy four of these. Good lord. What else are we? Is it any wonder I do? There's no. Luis just has amazing piano playing. Let me just stick the hammer on it. The problem is I can only get one side of the pull tech. I know we've only got one side in here, but just listen how much this pops in the mix. Is it any wonder I do? There's nothing better than a moment. Incredible. Alright, final thoughts. Alright, so what can I say other than this device has made me depressed purely because I can't afford 10 of them. It's, I mean, wow, that is just, it's remarkable, it's unbelievable. Now hold on just a second. Just look at it. This thing is a thing of beauty. It's, the build quality is absolutely unbelievable. It feels like an absolute tank. It's just, you know, you can see through the vents in the top and in the side, and there's just, they didn't waste the 2U, put it that way. It's absolutely stack full of gear. I just can't believe how heavy it is for a mono unit. Jesus Christ. I mean, I know the input and output transformers and all that kind of thing are weighty, but Jesus, it's just, I mean, it even smells good. It smells like EQ. Do you know what I mean? It just, I am going to have to procure some of these because this is just unacceptable that I live my life without them, frankly. Just, whoa, they were, all that time I thought, well, the A-Design's hammer. You know, that kind of, that's in the Pultec park. It does a Pultec thing. It doesn't though, does it? It sounds like shit in comparison to this. I don't have enough good things to say about this. I'm trying as best as I can be not to be biased because I've wanted to get my hands on one of these for ages. But even so, it's exceeded my expectations even more than I thought possible. This is, it just, it's a magical, magical device. And against the UAD plugin, well, I can see why everybody says it's not quite the same as the real thing, because it isn't, frankly. The UAD plugin is okay. It's in the ballpark, but is it a Pultec? No. No, it isn't. This is a Pultec. And for the price that AudioScape are charging for these, I mean, what's not to love? I think they're like $2,000 or something like that. 1,500 quid, something like that. They're not mega expensive, you know, when you bear in mind that a real Pultec's like $6,000. The AudioScape EQP-A. Thank you for joining me today. I'm going to go and weep tears of sorrow whilst I return this to its rightful owner. Join me next time where we look at another piece of outboard gear and face it off against one of my favourites. More to be revealed. See you next time.